Good afternoon, Americans. Good evening, Europeans and people in the UK. Howdy. Showtime here from my little writing room upstairs in Nashville, Tennessee. Mary Gauthier, Jaimee Harris here with you live on Sunday, September 20th, 2021. And we were just talking to James McMurtry and Michele who were in the green room about how every day sort of blends into the one before it and the next one. It's a blur of get up, have some coffee, watch the news, turn it off. Suddenly it's nighttime, you gotta eat, go to bed, get up, have coffee. It's a blur. It's just one day after the other of sort of a blur for us road dogs that are used to going from town to town, place to place, traveling and seeing different things on a regular basis. I'm so used to being on the road, and now this. So here we are. We're going to do this every Sunday until such time as we don't do this anymore. welcome to all the fans from the James McMurtry Facebook page. James is with us today. If you don't know me, I'm Mary Gauthier. I've been doing this with Jaimee Harris just about every Sunday since the end of March, since the COVID pandemic shut us down and all our gigs either got postponed or canceled. They quickly figured out how to get this technology up and running, and we've been doing this on Sunday afternoons for 6 months.
Yeah, I guess.
Can you even believe that's
I know.
Like another 3 months, we could have had a baby. But here we are. We're not having a baby. Let's get this show rolling. Everybody good? Welcome. Thank y'all for jumping in. At the downtown near the Roosevelt Bay. $48.50 if you pay in cash. Spanish television up through the floor. Desk clerk don't look up when I walk by anymore. Blizzard outside, blizzard in her heart. Lonely travelers, cheap motel hearts. Snow is falling on snow that fell on snow. I said, hold on, baby, don't let go. Trying to catch my breath, she moves so fast. Rumble strips, red lights, broken glass. Trouble. of dreams, a heart full of hurt. Friends say walk on, it's more trouble than it's worth. My will is gone, my head hangs low. It ain't the leaving, it's the way. Catch my breath, she moves so fast. Rumble strips, red lights, broken glass. Twisted steel, sirens. Trouble and love. Love and trouble, trouble. Figuring out how to do this with headphones. It should be half on and half off,
well,
right?
That's
with the habit all the way on, all I hear is guitar, and I can't hear my voice. And naturally, when I can't hear my voice, I can't hear the notes.
I just have that old studio habit of
I don't, not a studio.
I don't know if I'll ever break the habit.
Well, you've been in so many studios singing on people's records and such. That's not my life. When people ask me to sing on their record, I actually think they need therapy, but that's just my opinion. I'm getting better at
you're doing great. You sang
accompanying. I've just been this lone wolf for so long.
Well, you sang on that Malcolm Holcomb record in like one take. You just nailed it. You heard this really cool harmony, and you nailed it in one take. It was incredible.
She calls it a harmony. I call it the only notes I was capable of singing.
It was great.
One more song, and we'll bring the great James McMurtry onto the screen. Both Jaimee and I and Michele are all so excited today to have James with us. We're not just fans. We're verifiable super fans, each of us purchased every single one of this man's recordings, starting with the first record. It's the one I have from 1989, Too Long in the Wasteland, and then all the way up to The Complicated Game, 2015, and then there's a new one we're going to talk about when we bring him into the picture. But let's play another song before we do that. Just get me calmed down here. Crescent City disappearing in my rearview mirror, just like she's always done. Spend my life running from the ghost of the VUCA raid. Ah, that dirty spillway water in the noonday sun. Daughters of Charity left their mark on me. Keeping secrets, oh, it just makes you feel alone. Magazine Street stole from me. I never thought I'd find my way home. I thank God for you. I thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. I thank God for you. Just another junkie jonesing on a Greyhound bus with a 20-year ticket to a tortured mind. Sirens, sorrow, cigarette butts. My Jesus in pieces, broken as a highway line. I thank God for you. Thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. Thank God for you. Thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. You gave me something no one can take away. You saw right through me and loved me anyway. Thank God for you. Thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. I really do. Thank God for you. I thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. I thank God for you. Thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you.
Pickett Harris.
Yes, yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are bringing James McMurtry into the, I don't know what you call it, frame, into the frame, to the screen. Hi, James.
I've been framed. How we doing?
Oh, it's so good to have you with us. We have been really looking forward to this. Well, big
me,
time.
Me too. That's,
Oh, thank you. Thank you. You know, I'm going to embarrass Jaimee here for a second.
Oh, no.
She spent an awful lot of time at the Continental Club with you as a super fan. Years, actually.
Well, that's good to know.
How many years have you done that regular show at the Continental Club in Austin, Texas, when you're not on the road?
I believe we started in 2002.
Gosh,
so
man.
So every Wednesday when we were off the road, we were over there and And then when the gallery opened upstairs, I started doing a solo thing Tuesday nights at 8:30. So.
Now, you do that because you just love playing. You're committed to the.
Well, it's nice to have a little money too.
You do it for money. You do it for love. Yeah. You do it for. I mean, it's an institution at this point. I've been going on 20 years of that.
Well, yeah, and it was a good thing, and you know, it kept the band chops up. We didn't really have to rehearse all that much; just show up, and it toughens you up to play the Continental Club because you know, unless you're like the son of God or something, you don't get a sound check. You just show up and throw your gear on there and play.
Plug and play.
You get where you can do that, and you know, it's a good thing. It's you know, and of course, you know, I love the club, but it had probably the worst stage sound anywhere. So you learn to play without being able to hear yourself. and you know, they recreated
building.
That the Houston Club is exactly the same. They recreated that same monitor system somehow. I mean, sounds good out front, but band can't hear anything. But you know, you have to learn to work with that.
It builds character to be able to power through almost and maybe probably actually everything.
Yeah, but I miss it terribly.
Man.
This routine.
Yeah, we all do. We all do. I, you know, I was there for several of the different incarnations of that show, and there's always people there from all over the world, not just from all over Texas
States. To go to the club. I mean, even if they'd never heard of me, so it was a great career boost for me because people come in there just to say they'd been to the Continental Club, and I'm like, well, who's this guy? I'll stay for another drink, you know, that kind of thing. Worked pretty good.
There's always the people that come to the very front of the stage, know every single word of your songs, and sing with you.
Except for the ones that are faced away from the stage taking selfies. And, you know,
I'm actually here.
See, that's the thing that happened to Austin before the, you know, it was happening before the pandemic. You know, Austin kind of went Disneyland. And, you know, you'd be playing and suddenly 50 people would come in the door off a tour bus and they'd all get up front and stand around and take selfies and then they'd get back on the bus and leave. And I guess they all paid cover, so it's okay, but it's not the same vibe that it was back when Austin was a cheap town to live in. You know, you want to see what Austin used to be, you know watch Slacker. I mean, I was watching that show in that theater down there, I guess it's the Dolby. And the camera's panning through a parking lot, and somebody behind me says, "That's my car." It had only been made about 2 years before. You know, but that was the Austin we came for, and we stayed too long, I guess. I don't know.
Well, inevitably, if a place is cool, the end result is it's going to get discovered by somebody,
yeah.
Television creator who's going to then build a show around it and destroy. That's, you know, really interesting. We had the same phenomenon in Nashville. I used to play the Bluebird every about once every quarter or so, which is a regular gig for me, like four times a year. And then one time after that Nashville television show, I looked up and I realized I was playing for Miami Dolphin cheerleaders, like these like women that came. And they were gorgeous and perfect and physically unbelievably fit. And they came in three stretch limos. It was a wedding party for one of them. And I thought, man, you guys bought a ticket to the wrong show. I got nothing for you. And you know what turned out to be? I was wrong. They liked it. They wanted their pictures made and stuff. I don't know if they liked it as much as they...
Oh, I'm sure they were.
It was,
you know,
a sort of
they
a
not like it?
Sociological experiment for them, I guess. But they found something to like about it, I guess. I can't imagine they'd ever been in a venue with a gay troubadour singing sad songs before. But
they're from Miami.
They,
well, I bet they had.
they're dancing girls,
I've
James.
I've only ever played Miami proper one time. I don't remember the name of the dive, but I had the feeling that anything could happen there.
At any time.
For sure. No, I'm sure that was right up their alley. You know?
Well, they made me nervous, but, we learn to continue with what we have in front of us. You just keep going.
That's what we do. Yeah.
Before we turn you over for a couple of songs, I'd want folks to know you've done a record, a live record from the Continental Club that was recorded.
That's right, yeah. It's an EP. We managed to salvage five listenable songs out of that show. It was a video project that we did back for Compadre Records way back in the it was 2006, I guess it was. And I don't know why we decided to do a live video, but we did. And one of the things we didn't take into account, we shot that thing about 5 days after the smoking ban went into effect in Austin, Texas.
Oh, boy.
And we hadn't considered what the lack of cigarette smoke would do to stage lighting. So nobody thought to bring a fog machine. And it looked god-awful, just stark, you know. So we couldn't use it for a video, but and we didn't do anything with it. And then the guy that owned that label, or started the label, eventually he sold the label, and the new parent company fired him. So he got fired off his own label that he started. But then I think they scrapped the whole thing anyway. It was some, one of these corporate shenanigans. But Brad Turcotte wound up with the tapes from that show, the mixes anyway, and said, hey, you want to use, he called up after the pandemic and said, you want to use this stuff? You could use it for like a benefit for the Continental Club. It was his idea, actually. And I thought, sure, because the staff really needs something. Because, bar staff, you and me, we can stream, we can sell merch online, stuff like that, but nobody can mix a virtual margarita and serve it to anybody.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, we're worried about the clubs, and we're worried about the people who've worked there for forever. And this
it's the service industry is really, they had it hard anyway because, they don't make real wages in this country. They're working for tips almost entirely. They make far less than minimum wage on the assumption of a decent tip, and they have to claim on their taxes, they have to claim a percentage of their ring. So if you don't tip them, then they don't, it costs them money to serve you. So they had that to deal with, and now they just don't have any work. So this record is called Blasted from the Past. It's a 5-song EP, digital only. You get it off the internet, get it off my site, off the Continental site. But the proceeds are to benefit Continental Club staff.
100% of the proceeds are going to help the fine people who work in that legendary club in Austin, Texas, who right now are stranded and don't have any work, as so many of the venues, if not all.
Nationwide, I wish we could help them all, but, we'll try to help out our clubs.
If every musician helps out their home club, I think we make a difference.
That might help, they're saying touring's not really coming back till 2022.
Real touring is not coming back the way we had it, maybe not again in our lifetime, because the venues aren't going to be there.
Exactly. So, we need to help them out, see if we can keep them alive so there's a circuit to work when we get back on the road.
Absolutely. Jaimee and I will be working at the Bluebird doing a stream coming up on the 24th of September, I think. That's our home club here. Now that Jaimee lives here, it's certainly my home club. And I think if each musician picked one club to help, I think that would somehow make a dent. And you're leading the way with this record. I think it's a beautiful thing.
We would all benefit
thing.
From it.
We would all benefit because we have places to play. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Well done, sir.
No, thank you.
We'd love to hear some James McMurtry songs. Okay. We're going to put ourselves into the penalty box and turn it over to you.
I'm going to have to take my ears off here, so if it's not working, I'm not going to know. But
you got it.
I'll just smile and nod. Let's see here. I'm trying to get the frame right now. I don't know why I picked this song, but something... voices in my ear said, do this song first. My favorite t-shirt says, the voices aren't real, but they have good ideas. I saw Pete and Johnny too. dressed up in their Sunday suits, getting themselves all up to go down to Richmond to the traveling show. I fixed the gate like you told me to, done my chores like I always do. Now won't tell Mama you let me go down to Richmond to the traveling show. Please, Papa, can I go down to Richmond to the traveling show? Please, Papa, don't say I can't. I just want to see the elephants. I'll borrow the truck from Uncle Phil. You know I can drive it well. He won't need it now that the hay's all in. Just let me go and see the elephant. Please, Papa, can I go down to Richmond to the traveling show? Please, Papa, don't say I can't. I just want to see the elephant. Sister, she can't go with me. This is not for her to see. Little brother, you'll get your chance to go down and see the elephant. Little brother, you'll get your chance to go down and see the elephant. Please, Papa, can I go down to Richmond to the traveling show? Please, Papa, don't say I can't. I just want to see the elephant. They're looking for a few good men. Could be war by summer's end. Sure would hate it if I went. Never got to see the elephant. Sure would hate it if I went. Never got to see the elephant. I saw Pete and Johnny too. Dressed up in their navy blues, getting themselves all up to go down to Richmond to the traveling show. I think that's off a record called Childish Things. Mary was singing about New Orleans a while ago, so I wrote this song in New Orleans upstairs in one of the rooms over the R Bar on Royal Street in the Marigny District. Where I was just about the perfect amount of drunk and pissed off. Get that mixture right, you can write a song sometimes. Somebody doesn't kick your ass first. Thank you. The skies are taller in Louisiana. The skies are wider in New Mexico. The skies in Texas kind of split the difference. They don't suit me no matter where I go. I ain't got a place. I ain't got a place in this world. I ain't got a place. I ain't got a place in this world, I know. A river runs east out of West Virginia. Rivers run west down in Tennessee. A river runs north out of South Dakota. None of that makes a damn to me. I ain't got a place. I ain't got a place in this world. I ain't got a place. I ain't got a place in this world, I know. You ask me where I'm coming from, I'm not sure I can say. You ask me where I'm headed, I'll just grin. Don't ask too many questions, I'll be coming back to stay. You know not to ask me where I've been. I'm looking up at a constellation, looking down at the frozen ground, looking out for all my interests, looking in just brings me down. I ain't got a place, I ain't got a place in this world. I ain't got a place, I ain't got a place in this world. You know I ain't got a place, I ain't got a place in this world. I ain't got a place. I ain't got a place in this world, I know.
I don't know if you heard us or not, but that was a sing-along.
Get my ears on
here.
Oh,
this doesn't have his...
As the truckers used to say. Still there?
Oh yeah, we're singing along.
Okay. We're singing along here in my little office in Nashville. That was awesome.
You're in Nashville? What part of Nashville are you in?
I'm in Green Hills, right near 440.
You're past the Bluebird.
Yeah, right near the Bluebird, down, about a mile from the Bluebird.
Mm-hmm. South on Hillsboro.
Yep.
That way.
Yep.
Okay. I'm in Lockhart. I live in Lockhart, Texas.
How far is that from Austin?
It is 30 miles due south of the airport.
That's so interesting. I was going to answer your question with airport sort of distance. Like, yeah, a lot right and the left, and you're on the highway to the airport. We still think.
Yeah. Well, see, we got a toll road that goes through here. It doesn't go to Lockhart. It's basically one of those roads that Governor Rick Perry rammed through. It was built by a Spanish company that had him in his pocket, and it was supposed to alleviate the NAFTA truck traffic through Austin, because basically you get off of 35 at Seguin, or there's a cutoff that goes to Seguin, and then you get on 130, and you can go 85 miles an hour right up through here past Lockhart, because it's nice and flat. But there's very little truck traffic on it. You know, nobody uses that road unless they're in a hurry.
Yeah, well,
you know, trucking companies aren't going to spend that kind of money. You know, I guess the fuel is still cheap enough that they can bumper to bumper through Austin cheaper than they can get on 130.
Toll road.
Go around, yeah.
Yeah. It adds up fast.
Yeah.
So,
anyway,
30 miles from Austin could be an hour in some situations.
Not here. The thing about Lockhart is not on the way to anywhere. So there's not much traffic between here and Austin.
So it's a strategic move.
Yeah, it was the last place available. I mean, everybody got priced out of Austin. Musicians can't really live there anymore. Not many of them. And so everybody, you know, Dripping Springs filled up, and San Marcos filled up, and Bastrop filled up, and Lockhart was the last one left. So here we are. Good barbecue.
Yeah, great barbecue.
Smitty's.
Are you doing a regular? I see you on live stream sometimes on Facebook. Is it a regular thing, or do you do?
I do it every Wednesday at 8 o'clock Central. I call it hunkering in the bunker. Because a man's home is his bunker, isn't it? You know,
a man's home is his bunker these days, for sure. Yeah. And increasing amounts daily, apparently. Yeah, so 8 o'clock Wednesday nights, y'all check out a full James McMurtry show on his Facebook page, 8 o'clock Central Time in the U.S. You're going to have to do the math from your different time zones, although that's rough for Europeans and people in the U.K.
You know, once in a while, I'll do a Sunday for them.
There you go. We don't have a regular thing except for this, but every now and then we just get cabin fever and we just hit go live and just start playing, and somehow, boom, 150 people find us. I don't know how
that
works.
That's a good thing to do. Yeah. Sneak up on them that way.
This is so good, it's probably going to get taken away from us, don't you think? This works so well, somebody's going to figure out how to ruin it. It's good while it lasts, and we hope to take advantage of it. I think we're going to play one and then bring Michele in and then bring you back for several more rounds, if you don't mind.
Not a bit.
I'll pop you in the green room there.
All right.
This is, he said Rick Perry, didn't he?
He did say Rick Perry.
This is a song about selling your soul. I guess the question is, if you sell your soul in service of what you think is good, do you still go to hell? What would people say about that? Attempt to do good, you're still doing evil, according to Mary Gauthier. Black clouds blowing across a blustery sky. Black clouds blowing across a blustery sky. South of Highway 7, all alone, crying, oh soul, I sold you away. When you sell your soul, it opens a deep, dark hole. When you sell your soul, it opens a deep, dark hole. Drink will leave you thirsty, fire will leave you cold, oh soul, I sold you away. And I'm singing, oh my soul, I sold you away. Oh my soul, I sold you away. Oh, my soul, I sold you away. Oh, soul, I sold you away. Well, it started with desire, sweet, soft kiss. Started with desire, sweet, soft kiss. Face against a fist, oh soul, I sold you away. Now I'm singing, oh my soul, I sold you away. Oh my soul, I sold you away. Oh my soul, I sold you away, oh soul, have mercy on me. Redemption, redemption, have mercy on me. The body is a prison when the soul's a refugee. Oh soul, I sold you away. Now I'm pulling into Greenwood to get down on my knees. Pulling into Greenwood to get down on my knees. By Robert Johnson's grave, pray my soul back to me. Oh soul, I sold you away. I'm singing, oh my soul, I sold you away. Oh my soul, I sold you away. Note there, Harris. That was a new move there.
I don't know what I did, but
I liked it a lot. Let's bring in the maestro, Michele.
Ciao, Jaimee. What a great song, oh my soul, every time I listen to it. What a great song.
Thank you. Wrote that with Ben Glover.
Oh, yes. And I remember many times we played this song, and I remember some surreal moments when we played this song in churches, and there were all these people singing in a choir, oh, my soul, I sold you away. That was so surreal and so great in some way. I remember in Belfast also, the church and many other churches.
I do. I remember a packed church in Belfast. We had the congregation singing, yes. Oh, my soul, I sold you away.
Yes.
It was a wonderful moment.
Yes.
I remember that myself. How are you, my friend?
I'm good. Good. Considering the situation, I am good. And like every musician, I tell this every week, I'm sick of this, so I'm trying to survive and doing weird things, learning to play weird instruments, like, for example, kalimba. I am reading again T.S. Eliot, The Wasteland. So, yes, we are too long in the wasteland, like James McMurtry should say. And so I'm doing this thing. We didn't have time on the road. So I'm learning kalimba and I'm reading T.S. Eliot. So that's interesting in some way. But I am sick. I'm really sick. And I'm looking for the day till I see you again,
yeah,
face by face.
This is an endurance test.
And, oh, yes.
we are going to endure. We are going to do what it takes to get through this. This will have a beginning, a middle, and an end, and we've got to stay within the parameter of safety until this ends. And we are wondering here in America, how's Italy in general? You said schools are back in session for the children and the universities,
yes,
too?
And almost the university too, but now the children, the middle school and the high school are now open. And I am worried, but everybody is worried because schools are open. They say that there is a distance between students, but actually there is not. The school are still the same. So I don't know what will happen. So it's really, 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 really dangerous. But probably they wanted to maybe try to do something. But it's really, really dangerous. My son, for example, is at school, and his classroom looks exactly the same. So it's really, I don't know what will happen.
Oh, boy. Well, pretty sure we do know what will happen. We're going to go round two in Italy, probably, with the COVID-19. It's going to be a second wave, I would imagine. It doesn't take a genius.
Yes.
It's exactly the same classroom as it was before. I hope not. Round one was so horrible in Italy.
Yes, I hope so. And you know, in my part, in my region was really hard. COVID already hit hard. So I hope the second wave, at least, will be milder than the first wave.
And more treatments to keep people off the ventilators.
Yes, at least they know better what to do right now, because when it happened in early March in Italy, it was something really new and unusual for all the Western world. So everything began here, and they tried to find some ways to cure it, but at the beginning, obviously, it was difficult. It was chaos. Now everything is more organized. So hopefully the second wave will be mild. I hope so. Manageable, right.
Yeah, I hope so too, my friend. So what have you got for us today? Are you going to play that little instrument?
Yes. No. Next week, I guess. For this week, I think I will keep playing my violin, and for this week, we're gonna see next one. And I really loved another Mary Gauthier Ben Glover song that you played, a new one, "Till I See You Again," and I really loved the song because it's a song of that brings comfort to all of us. To me personally, but to everybody. And so I learned listening to that song that yes, one day I will see you, I will see my friends again, but I have to learn to live in this situation, to rest in gentle arm, and to try to survive and to live in a nicer way this day too. And so I loved the way the lyrics are written, because it's a wish that until we see again, we all survive not in a horrible way, but also we can have love anyway, for example. But I will play an instrumental version of this song. I love the guitar part, and I love the melody. So I try to do something. It's really unusual, I will try. And I hope you like it. And Ben, maybe it's like a homage to this beautiful, beautiful song.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank you,
Can't
Mary.
Can't wait to hear what you've done.
Bring my violin.
Absolutely beautiful, maestro.
Thank you, Mary. Thank you, Mary. I love this song.
Thank you. I can't wait to get on stage and play it with you.
Me too, me too. As you know, it will happen. It will happen. We know that.
It will happen. It will happen. Always good to see you, my friend. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Mary. Thank you, Jaimee, for your help every day in this thing.
We love you.
We love you, Michele.
Ciao, Jaimee, and I am waiting to listen to your new album.
Thank you, Michele.
Yes, yeah.
Thank you.
Can't wait.
I'll send you some. Thank you.
Send me.
I'll send you some songs.
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Thank you, maestro.
Ciao.
I'm gonna go ahead and play that song that Michele just played and add the words. May eternity hold you in the hollow of her hand. May a soft wind enfold you as you travel distant lands. May the moon stars delight you. Daylight dims till the morning sun warms your face till I see you again. May you lay down your struggle beneath the silver sky. May a summer rain inside your dreams whisper lullabies. May there be no more sorrow and no more pain. You sleep inside the stillness of the night till I see you again. May you never be a stranger. May you never feel alone. May you reunite with family and friends, and may they walk you home. May love embrace you. Dance that never ends. May you rest in gentle arms till I see you again. May you rest in gentle arms till I see you. Jaimee, lovely guitar part.
Thank you.
Let's bring James back in.
All right.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm back.
I can
Not
get used
ever
to
left,
this.
Really. Yeah. If anybody wants me, I'll be right here. That's just kind of how it is right now.
We're not going anywhere either.
Yeah. Well, y'all seem to be getting on okay. I don't know.
We're doing all right, you know. We've got, Jaimee's got an office three flights down, and she spends a lot of time in it with the door closed. She's got a Pro Tools rig now, and she's recording and singing backups on people's records and working on demos and doing a lot of stuff up there. I've been up here writing a book and finishing it up and working on stuff.
That's good.
Sort of meet for dinner in the middle there.
Yeah,
on the
stay out of each
floor.
Other's way. That's it. Like Kelly and I are pretty good at that too.
Yeah.
We're all on one level, but you know, yeah, neither of us talk too much, so I said, you know, it's all right.
Yeah, you got to figure out a way to, and we did figure out a way to create some space in a space, and gather for dinner, basically. And try not to interrupt each other. If I keep shouting down there, hey, what do you think about, it just interrupts the flow. So trying to not do that.
Yeah, they're rule
so
number
much.
One, shut up.
Yeah. Number one, don't interrupt the flow of someone's thinking, which
exactly.
I'm guilty of.
Well, yeah, I think maybe I'll do a song about for all the people that aren't getting along so well, because I know that for some pairs of people out there, this is torture. But you'll make it through, guys. It'll be all right. But anyway,
I know that a lot of musicians' wives are like, I can't wait for you to get back on the damn road.
Well, that's the thing, yeah. Kelly,
you like I got used to you being gone. This is not working for me.
Yeah, you know, and the dogs are both looking at me going, when are you going to leave? Aren't you going to work? But,
We're going to put ourselves into the green room. Play us a couple more songs, if you would, James McMurtry.
I'll play us some songs, okay.
Thank you.
Oh, that's right, this round back guitar. I gotta do this. It's really hard. Beyond a certain age. Bills are paid, but it makes no difference to the gods that seem to rule our home. The heat shut off for no known reason. This old building's got a mind of its own. I can tell your footsteps on the stairs from three flights up, and I know the jingling of your keys. You won't hear no, and you don't look back, and you can't slow down. And these days you don't have much to say to me. In another town, what would fetch a good living? Here's barely hand to mouth. So I'm going out and get a U-Haul trailer and drag it down the turnpike south, where the Garden State gives way to the real world and falls away in the rear view mirror. We'll mend our wounds and wait out the winter down across the Delaware. We get along in a manner of speaking. We rarely have to speak at all. Small talk over takeout pizza, silently passing in the hall. Post-it notes, opposite shifts. Once in a blue moon, we'll wake up in the same room. Thankful for these thy many gifts. We run by night, we live it and breathe it. We're the best of the best, and I just don't care. Gonna mend my wounds and wait out the winter down across the Delaware. And I'll see you in the spring when the chill don't cut so deep. I'll be back around to give this town another crack at me. Thank you. voice today, I swore I knew. From somewhere down in the southern sticks, I turned around to see some ragged stranger bumming change on the uptown six, and I froze like a stone. Could I ever get that low? Turn my face to the window. There, by the grace of God, I go, where the Garden State gives way to the real world and falls away in the rearview mirror. I'll mend my wounds and wait out the winter down across the Delaware. That's an old song. There were those for whom quarantine was a way of life already, I guess. Supposed to stick to music, but being me, I'm going to go ahead and delve into politics and social commentary. My brother's a fascist, lives in Palacios, fishes the pier every night. He holsters his Glock in a double retention. He smokes while he waits for a bite. He don't like the Muslims, he don't like the Jews, he don't like the blacks, and he don't trust the news. He hates the Hispanics and alternate views. He'll tell you it's tough to be white. My sister's a Christian, she likes to go fishing, she don't mind my brother at all. He puts her on redfish and flounder and specks, and they tear up the flats in the fall. She gets back to Dallas all sunburnt and sour, worn out from slinging plugs hour after hour, seeing spots when she closes her eyes in the shower. She don't see a conflict at all. That's the state of the union, I guess. It's always been iffy at best. We're all in the family, the cursed and the blessed. It's the state of the union, I guess. Now mother turned 80. Consummate lady, we took her to Golden Corral. Cause she likes the yeast rolls and the Bourbon Street chicken. We oughta known better by now. Cause me and my brother got into it good. I called him a hick and he called me a hood. He said Dad always treated his Mexicans good. I guess you think you're better somehow. Yeah, you think you're better, Mr. Cardigan Sweater, Snowflake if ever there was. You think you're so cool, you did good in school, you got whooped every day on the bus. Sister lit out for the shouting got worse. Went to Wednesday night prayer at the new Christian church with a cross on her neck and a nine in her purse. She might be the wisest of us. That's the state of the union, I say. Christmas dinner could be hell to pay. It'll be how about them cowboys and have a blessed day. It's the state of the union, I say. It's the state of the union, I guess. We're all in a hell of a mess. We'll do all we're able with what we got left. It's the state of the union, I guess. We'll do all we're able with what we got left. It's the state of the union, I guess.
Oh, yes.
Fantastic.
Yes, yes, yes. That's not politics. That's family. Mm-hmm. I guess you met my family.
Yeah. I think we must be related.
Yeah. How long has that song been kicking around?
Oh, a couple of years. A
couple of years?
Yeah.
I think I wrote it
in 2017, maybe, somewhere like that. Yeah.
Whew. It just nails it. It just nails it. It's it's the best way to talk about the bigness of everything. You do it by getting small.
I guess, yeah.
The individual
stories. The microcosm approach, yeah.
Yeah, it's such great writing, James. Such,
thank you.
Such great writing and such a familiar cast of characters. Oh, God. Well, I'm going to have Jaimee play a song.
Do that.
She's got a brand new song. I'm voting for it to be title track of a new record when she's going to the studio. She's still interviewing producers and such, but I think this is a song that definitely I would... Don't want to embarrass you, but I think you've been definitely influenced by James's writing on some of this song, don't you think?
It's hard. Yes.
Yeah.
Just say yes. I mean, I'm just a huge yes.
Yeah.
Huge student of James McMurtry.
Remember that time we were somewhere on the road and I said, "Oh my God, we just drove into a James McMurtry song."
I do remember where we. Yes.
Where the hell were we?
Oh, I don't remember. It was somewhere. I don't even remember.
Probably Oklahoma. You were probably on US 69 somewhere around Tushka, Oklahoma, because that is, I stole that road for a song, and then everything along that road disappeared after I wrote the song. Speaking of Oklahoma, that line about pulling into Greenwood, is that Tulsa you're talking about?
Greenwood, Mississippi.
Okay, because there's also a district in Tulsa. Where some real bad stuff happened. But,
was that where the massacre was?
Yeah.
The race riot. Yeah. The white race riot.
Yeah, that part
Let's just clarify who was rioting.
Yeah, that town's haunted pretty bad.
They're digging up bones there, trying to get the story. Literally, archaeologists are trying to find the bodies and get the actual story. It's unbelievable. The story of the Tulsa riots was just unbelievable.
Yeah.
I didn't know it was a section of town called Greenwood.
I believe it is.
So,
I could be wrong. Sometimes I'm wrong, but you can Google it. You can find out real fast.
I'll look it up. Jaimee Harris.
Thank you. Sure.
Be right back with James. But first, I want Jaimee to play this.
I was working at the supermarket when I fell for Julie, knocked her up like everybody said I would. The day I turned 16, I got that. In all August, I asked Julie if she'd run away. She said she wanted to wait till May to graduate. She'd be the first in her family, so I stayed behind. Thought she could get a scholarship to college, become a nurse, travel the world, but all that took a back seat when we saw those double lines. As for me, the only dream I've ever had is getting out of this boomerang tan. Next to the seminary. She serves the truckers, the troubadours, the punks, the college kids who trash their booths all stoned and drunk, who always pay but never tip with daddy's money. Similar kin. Heavy drinkers, quick to anger's fist to skin. They all live and die. That won't be us, I swore to her. I promise you we'll see. Just don't know when. As for me, the only dream I've ever had is getting out of this boomerang tan. You think you're soaring, you think you're flying. To know there's no use trying. You span in circles, round and round in this boomerang town. It's a ship. She lights a smoke up on the bridge under the billboard painted Jesus Lives. Julie steps over the rail, thinks about salvation. The sun arrives in collapse. steeple, cast a shadow over God's most desperate people. Julie takes it as a sign. Let's go and start flying. As for me, the only dream I've ever had is getting out of this boomerang town. It feels like soaring, it feels like flying. Now I know it's only dying. You spin in circles, round and round in this. It's a boomerang
town. Oh, man, I love that song so much, Jaimee.
Thank you. That's
it's a monster song. I just can't even find the exact way to describe it, except that's going to be a big song for you. And it describes so many people's reality. I think you just nailed it.
Thank you.
I love that song.
Thank you.
I love it. And I guess we're going to get another one from James. But before we do, I want to let everybody on the stream know that the tips are greatly appreciated. And we distribute it among all four of us. It'll be sent to everyone on the screen by the end of the day tomorrow, because this will get viewed again tonight in different time zones. So by the end of the day tomorrow, I'll share it with everybody. And it really is generous of you, and we do appreciate it, and we don't expect it. Tips are not required. We want you just to listen and be a part of our community. But when you do tip, we do appreciate it. Two things I want to mention. If you get on the mailing list, we'll let you know when we're going to do pop-up shows. I have a bunch of new songs, and Jaimee has a bunch of new songs, and we'll pop up during the week when the weather's right and we feel like it, without warning. We'll let you know if you get on the mailing list. Also, I've been teaching online during the pandemic, and I've got two master classes coming up, and that will be October 3rd and October 10th. It's a package deal. You can buy both of them. It's a 12-person class, and we have four seats left. So when those four seats are sold, we're going to be sold out, and keeping the class small on purpose. So that's two Saturdays, the first two Saturdays of October. And we'll class at 11:30 a.m. Central Time. So if you're in Europe or the U.K., that could work. What else do I want? One more thing. The bundle. This is the bundle. Every record I've made in my life is in this bundle. 10 CDs, all 10. In this box, I call a bundle. And it comes with a protective mask that says Mercy. Not too big, but big enough for people to know you believe in it. It's a cloth mask, very soft mask. So if you go to my store and get the bundle, that'll sure help a lot, and I will appreciate it greatly. And as always, I would be more than happy to write out by hand your favorite Mary Gauthier song onto a lyric sheet and put that in a nice protected envelope. That's a good gift for someone who really wants to have something personal. I can say happy birthday, happy anniversary to whoever and sign it. That is also up on the website. And James is also selling an EP that benefits the staff of the Continental Club in Austin. A very generous thing and an important thing. And we're going to start really talking about musicians helping their home club to stay alive during this time. If we all surround one club in our town, we're going to have places to play when this is over. Jaimee and I are going to focus on the Bluebird Cafe here in Nashville. We'd love to bring James back for one more song and a final close it out with James McMurtry at 3:27. It's just about perfect timing, which is hard to do. So well done to all of us.
Good for us, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for having me on, Mary. It's an honor to be on the screen with y'all and Michele over in Italy. I was wondering if Michele could pass on to say hi to some friends of mine over there. Paolo Caru from Buscadero and Andrea Parodi, who used to book my shows. If they're not watching, maybe he could pass my regards on to them.
He definitely will.
Yeah, they helped me out a lot.
Yeah. Bring Michele on.
Yeah, let's bring in Michele.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. I'm going to do that. Paolo and Andrea are my friends, too. So, sure.
Are you up north where they are, up around Milano?
Paolo Caru is in Gallarate, not too far from Milano, and Andrea lives not too far from there, near Cantù, Como, that area, Milano.
Where are you?
Now I am outside of Venice, still in the north of Italy, northeast.
Yeah, it all kind of runs together, as I recall.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and I am in touch with them, and for sure, maybe they are also watching right now. I'm gonna check.
Yeah, well, I hope to see you all again.
Yes. It will happen.
We are also absolutely indebted to and for Paolo Caru and Andrea Parodi. Caru has the smallest record store on earth, right? You walk in and you don't. It's not even a. It's just, you walk, there's...
Well, he's got a bookstore, too. He's got a world-class bookstore.
Yeah, his wife's got the bookstore upstairs, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
And he has this little
perfect marriage.
He rolls up a grate, and it's just, you stand there and point to what you want, and they hand you the records. It's incredible. And then he has the magazine, Buscadero, which covers basically American roots music, I think, if I'm not mistaken.
No. Yes. And it's going on since 1981. So it's a long time, Buscadero, and still alive every month. So I'm so happy for that. And I personally discover all the Americana scene through Paolo Caru and Buscadero, for sure. You, Mary.
Yeah,
so I am really grateful.
Yeah, that's probably why I got to go to Italy a couple of times.
Yes. So come back.
I will try.
Mm-hmm. Same here.
I don't miss lugging the gear, but I miss the food.
Yes.
That's what I miss about touring. I don't miss so much that, you know, that the drums beating you in the ear at 5 in the afternoon and the feedback doing the sound checks, but I do miss the food everywhere.
Yeah.
The Red
too.
Iguana in Salt Lake City.
The
Wiener Circle in Lincoln Park.
Yes.
That mole, the Red Iguana.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. We musicians know the town by the restaurant and the venue.
That's what it is.
Yes.
And the record store.
Well, y'all mentioned Belfast, and the image that came to mind was this little storefront Indian restaurant down the street from the Errigal Inn, that where I had the best vindaloo I've ever had, and it was so hot there were tears streaming out my eyes, and I couldn't stop. I could not stop eating it.
I know the place, and we played at the Errigal Inn for years and years and years. The cook there was really good too, the chef really, but that Indian food, I do know it. It is the hottest of the hot. Ben, our friend Ben Glover that we tour with, always gets the vindaloo, and he's from Belfast, a pale Irish lad, and it's like it just comes pouring off his face, and he just wipes his face and keeps eating it.
Yeah, you can't stop. I mean, and that's just the vindaloo. I don't even dare touch the fall.
No.
I mean, too hot for me.
God. Now we're all just dying to get back.
Yeah, we gotta go eat. I'm gonna do a song. There's a guy from Germany supposed to interview me. He's waiting down on the courthouse square by the Caldwell County Courthouse. His name's Hubert. If he's watching on his phone, I'll be there in a minute.
2 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay.
James will take us out. Thank you again, James and Michele. Thank you.
Thank you all.
All right. I'll go out with one off my new record that's uncharacteristically positive towards the human race. Some years ago, I was complaining about something. My cousin Mitch said, "Knock it off, James. If it don't bleed, it don't matter." So. Looking back down the road from a little ways out, I never had a fear and I never had a doubt. If it had a lick of sense, I'd have figured that out pretty fast. But I wasn't any smarter than the average kid. Somebody might have noticed, but I never did. I never saw the future fading right into the past. Talking to the wallpaper, wandering the halls, I burned a lot of bridges and I dropped a lot of balls. It's a wonder I can never go back to any place I've been. But I wouldn't get down on my knees on a bet. I'm near enough to Jesus as I ever want to get. Seeking salvation isn't part of my general plan. Save your prayers for yourself. Raise my glass to your health. I don't mind if you don't look like me. I can share my bread and wine. I come from another time. It don't matter all that much if it don't bleed. If it don't bleed. Now it's all I can do just to get out of bed. There's more in the mirror than there is up ahead. I smile and I nod like I heard what you said every time. So run another rack, pour another shot. You don't get it back, so give it all you got. While you still got a more or less functional body and mind. Save your prayers for yourself. Raise my glass to your health. I don't mind if you don't look like me. I can share my bread and wine. I come from another time. It don't matter all that much if it don't bleed. If it don't bleed. My calls and open my mail. I paid my taxes and I stayed out of jail. You stay in the game when you're too broke to fail. That's a fact. Talking to the wallpaper, sleeping in the halls. Your bones get brittle, so you better not fall. You're slow to a crawl and time gets to ball in the jack. Ball in the jack. Save your prayers for yourself. Raise my glass to your health. I don't mind if you don't look like me. I can share my bread and wine. I come from another time. It don't matter all that much if it don't bleed. If it don't bleed. If it don't bleed. If it don't bleed. It don't bleed.
And we will see you all next week, same time, same place. Thanks for joining us, James McMurtry, Michele Gazic, Jaimee Harris, 2 o'clock Central. Next week we will be here, and I'm going to play a bunch of new songs, and Jaimee is too. So we'll see you then. Thanks, everyone. Take care. Take good care.